Hills, and Moreland. Those four will transfer to the main event. Heat race number two, getting ready to roll. Coming to the green flag. They're working through three. Mitchell and Miller on the front row. McDowell, Watts, second row. Green flag out.
Back to turn three, he rolls
picking up the heat race win, heat race number three. Casey Roberts and Covert back there for the third and fourth spots. A little bit of beat and bang there to get by. Ferguson and Rambo, front row, Long and Fry, second row, Satterley and Mitchell, third row, green flag out. Ferguson gets a quick jump on the field down to turn one. He's going to take advantage of that pole spot.
Okay.
officials out on the speedway. We're going to check this in a second. Two lucky young fans selected out of the crowd. They're going to be our pace truck drivers tonight for our main event. But we're getting ready to go back to action. Seven laps in, five to go. Elliott's going to lead them back to the green. Watson Satterley. Well, Watson Bradshaw touched. Now Satterley. He slides high. Sarah will get by him. Bradshaw slides high as well. The 47 of Quaid, he's up to the transfer spot now. Watch him there. They're going to fight it out for the sixth spot.
Trying to break into your 75 collected in that as well. Of Kent Hamilton sitting in third. He knows he's got Dan Arnold right behind him.
Contact Julianne in our sales office for a tour of Beth Page today.
Race fans looking to go green flag racing this time. Question is, can Brett Hamilton advance himself? Is Dan Arnold going to get the spot away? Green flag is back out. Six laps on the board. 25, the distance to make this a race. And your field launches himself like rockets down to turn number one. Dan Arnold trying to take a peek down to the inside, but Brett Hamilton says, ABC base on me. He is not moving anywhere. Doby now taking a look down to the inside of the car number five of Dan Arnold. They touch just a little bit here on the front stretch. Ryan Doby trying to make his way into your top four, and it looks like he's going to try to master that low line. Dan Arnold now backing away from Brett Hamilton, your top three drivers now trying to motor away. Doby once again to the inside of Arnold. Arnold's real high off turn three and four, and Brian Doby just took it away. Now they're three wide racing down the front stretch. Dan Arnold up high. Joey Polavoy was on the bottom side. Sparks was in the center. Now Dan Arnold splits them up right there in turns one and two. He's trying to make his way back up into your top five as he drops outside of your top five. And now Sparks going to make his way to the fifth spot. In your right order with nine laps on the board of 25. Meanwhile, down to turn number one, Brett Hamilton still sitting in the same spot he has been for the entire race. Drivers all trying to make their way down to turn three and four, the quickest. That's where your leader, Chris Arnold, is. He's got the bottom side of the racetrack reeled down. Pat, now looks like Paige Pearson going to have some pressure from behind for Brett Hamilton. Hamilton still in third as it looks like second, third, fourth, and fifth have fallen back drastically from your leaders off turn number two. Chris Arnold looks so patient as he enters the corner. Meanwhile, just to mention, Neil Hudgens off turn number two right now. He is way off the pace, but it looks like he's having some issues. Meanwhile, back up front. Or not up front. Looks like Galloway having some issues. He has a tire going down, almost pulls right in front of Francis Jarrell. Galloway pulls off the speedway after almost collecting Francis Jarrell in that car 01. And Galloway is now off the speedway. He is done. Meanwhile, back up front. Awesome race going on. Looks like for your third, fourth, and fifth spot, Chris Arnold's pulled out about four car lengths over the car number 71 of Harrison. Doby now trying to look down to the inside of Brett Hamilton. That's your battle for your third spot down to turn number three and four. All the drivers really nursing the bottom side of the speedway. Meanwhile, caution flag is out again, and this will put us under caution flag lap number 12 as the car number 99 goes around. Charlie Hubbard again having some issues around in turn number two. All with a big task on their hands. How can they catch? Gregor Flagman about ready to give them the green flag this time by, folks. Are you ready to see them go green flag action racing once again? That's pretty weak. We'll work on it. We'll work on it. Chris Arnold this time off turn number four, looking for your green flag, and grabs it away down the front stretch, and Paige Pearson. Paige Pearson second, looks like he's going to back off about four car lengths away from your leader that time. Brett Hamilton still, rear view mirror full of Doby. Doby's in your fourth spot. Dan Arnold trying to break his way into fourth. He's looking down to the inside of Doby. Halfway that time by, 13 down. About 12 more to go this time by. Single file right there. And Chris Arnold just really patient on the entry of these corners because he is so fast out. It looks like he is just the one that goes the slowest down into the corners, really nurses the entry of the corner, and just really gets on the loud pedal coming off. One driver into the wall outside of turns one and two. He's stopped in the middle of the racetrack. And that's going to be Mike Reynolds in your car number 21, bringing out the caution flag. It looks like something broke on that machine to cause him to stop right in the apex of the corner. Angle lap number 14 of 25. Chris Arnold, Paige Harrison, Brett Hamilton, Brian Doby, and Dan Arnold, your top five. Drivers now all in their seats, reduced now to nothing but their thoughts as all of the drivers trying to get up. racing off turn number four that time. Brian Dolby well inside of your Carnival 1ST and Brett Hamilton. That's about as far as anyone's gotten on Brett Hamilton, as far as them trying to pass him. And Brian Dolby looks like he's got a nose on him down the back stretch. Side by side for your third spot in return three and four right there. And still Brett Hamilton trying to outpower him on the outside. Brett Hamilton does so on the outside, leading him down to turn number one. Still trying to stalk him up the speedway off of turn number two. They're still side by side. Meanwhile, battle for your sixth spot continues. It's going to be Jimmy Duncan and Joey Polavoy as they touch a little entering turn three and four. They still race off turn number four. Jimmy Duncan with that low side line on Joey Polavoy down to turn number one. That's your battle for your sixth spot. Meanwhile, battle to the third still continues. Brian Dolby still on the inside of Brett Hamilton. All the way up to the front spot. It looks like Chris Arnold still has your lead. Paige Harrison looking for the win in that car number 71. Brett Hamilton actually looks like he's enjoying the top side of that racetrack, but Brian Dolby gets by. Hamilton goes back one spot. Hamilton's still going to try to pass him on the outside. Turn three and four. Brett Hamilton really mashing him down on the berm there. Turn three and four. And Brian Dolby secures the spot. Caution flag flies. And I believe that's Neil Hutchins. It is. That goes around in turn number one and two. Right there in the apex where we saw the caution fly previously. And Neil Hutchins was actually having problems a few laps previous. Turns one and two. The caution flag in lap number 19. This time around, hold up, yellow flag. Giving them the one signal. That signals the field. One more time around under caution. They will receive the green flag this time. Should be the last green flag if everything works out kosher. Paige Harrison, Brett Hamilton, Ryan Dolby. Dan Arnold in the car 5W, Joey Polavoy trying to make his way into the top five. Neil Hutchins trying the high side of the racetrack, the very end of the field. Green flag is out, underway once again, and Chris Arnold will make his way down to turn one with a fierce field behind him. Dolby looks to the inside of the car 1ST of Brett Hamilton. Hamilton's got other plans though. Pulls it to the high side of the car 71. Paige Harrison can't make it happen. Battle for your second continues here down the front stretch. Five laps to go this time. Brett Hamilton right now trying to get that second spot away from Paige Harrison. Meanwhile, Chris Arnold in the car number 99. Out of turn number four, looking at four laps to go. This time by, they're now all jumbled up now for your second spot, and it's Brian Dolby to the top of the speedway. Dolby at the top of the speedway, down in turns one and two. Brett Hamilton now has that second spot. Where did that power come from? Brian Dolby trying to look down to the inside of Brett Hamilton in the car 1ST. Laps are winding down, and he has the inside of Brett Hamilton covered. Now he's trying to get that second spot away. Brian Dolby, who's made his way up through the field, certainly outside of row number four in eighth position. Now trying to get your second away from Brett Hamilton. Two laps to go this time by for the car number 99 of Chris Arnold. Shooting at that time, Chris Arnold looking for the white flag as he comes across this time in that car number 99. And the white flag flies. Brett Hamilton too far back to try to make it happen. The battle still continues right there with Brian Dolby to the inside. Brian Dolby to the line. Chris Arnold takes the checkered flag. Brian Dolby grabs second away from Brett Hamilton, finishing in third. Fourth spot going to be the car number 71 of Paige Harrison. Ran second most of the night, but rounds out fourth out of Brian Dolby, and Brett Hamilton got the spots away. Thank you.
of turn four. Here we go. Madden and Miller side by side. They're bunching up. Here we go. Green flags out. Madden Miller racing down towards turn one. They're still side by side. Miller getting a jump on the outside. Ferguson there for third. McDowell, they jumble up. That mid-pack. Rambo in his rifle. He was part of that. Kid Quick on the outside there. Roberts to the inside. This time by one in the bus. It'll be Miller. Ferguson, McDowell, got one sliding high, Schaefer sliding high there in turns one and two, got two way up against the wall, they hang on, keep it straight. They did everything but wreck. They're three wide back coming off of turn four, that's golf. And several more. Ferguson working the higher side. McDowell able to get to the very bottom of the speedway. Ferguson fins him off for now, but McDowell still under the gun. Got him to the inside. Ferguson's cart won't hold the bottom quite like McDowell. That's a still side-by-side. Now Ferguson cuts out front. McDowell again able to take it to the very bottom. Is there? No, they're still fighting. Ferguson hanging on through the outside. Battle right behind them. Job by McDowell right up in front of Ferguson off of turn two. Great battle back there in the fifth, sixth, and seventh spot. Still clean and green through lap number six. Now seven. This time by was Miller, Madden, McDowell, Ferguson, Latham, Eckert, Shaver, Franklin, Moorhead, and Mitchell. Second between Madden and McDowell. McDowell up to the rear bumper of Madden as they work through lap traffic. See a lot of damage on the right rear of Miller's machine. McDowell right to the inside of Madden. Madden keeps him pinched down low. Can't make the pass that time. McDowell seems to have the track figured out on the very bottom of the racetrack. But Madden sticks the nose just as low this time through three and four. In the fourth spot, Jamie Luckham. 57, Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell. Another tough break for him. Flat left rear on Zach Mitchell. Flat left rear on the 57 car. Kid Quick, Zach Mitchell, the caution for a flat left rear. So we'll go back. of turn two. This could get real interesting between McDowell and Madden. That's two very seasoned veterans out there. Getting ready to go green. Here we go. Miller, McDowell, Madden.
Green flag out. Ferguson swung it way high coming off of Ford. Everybody makes it clean and green through one and two. Miller, Madden, McDowell, Ferguson. Shaver moved up.
Miller, Shaver, McDowell, then Eckert. Ferguson.
Shaver down to the inside. Miller keeps it cut off and pinched down. Shaver again will try the inside. Very bottom of the speedway. Shaver to the inside. Time. Virginia Motor Speedway. Picked up 10 grand last year, 10 grand again tonight. Steve, come on around, buddy. Congratulations, Steve. Man, you worked your way up from back in the field just a little bit. Tell us how the race went tonight. You waited to the very end. How'd you make that pass?
Well, it wasn't on purpose. I was trying to do it earlier, but I just want to say thanks to Kevin, Leroy, and Brian for putting this car together. I mean, this is a brand new car. It has new laps on it. The motor's all fresh, brand new. And boy, what a difference it made. It was very little changes tonight. Rocket chassis got their program together, and Kevin put his super touch on it. But it was just a great night. We picked the right tires. We probably went a little harder than most people, but I knew at the end I'd have something to be able to move around with.
Well, Steve, again, this is a back-to-back for the Ultimate Series here for you. $10,000 win last year in the heat last July. A little cooler night, but you're still sweating up a storm, buddy.
Yeah, it was a little hot in there, but we were busy. Jeremy drove a great race, and I didn't want to get into him, so I just tried to drive as clean as I could, and I knew there wasn't any getting him off the bottom, so I thought I got to try to make this outside work, and went in a couple times, and it stuck, and I thought, well, I'm going to go after it, and it worked for us.
Steve, let's give you a big congratulations. But how about your sponsors here? I do this for fun.
Oh, yeah. GPS Supply, CB Products, Posky's Performance Parts, Hoosier Tires, Sunoco Race Fuels, all those people. Without all their help, we wouldn't be able to do it. I want to thank my son, too. He was with me. He kept me busy on the drive down here. We had like an 8-hour drive down here, but we had fun, and this makes it a lot more fun to drive home.
There you go. Congratulations, Steve Shaver, your winner tonight here at Virginia Motor Speedway.
Let's get in here. I'm telling you what, son. You lead three laps total. Lap 36 by nose at the line, and then the last two. And you went inside. You kept testing outside. And then you did it right at a turn two with an outside move, Jeremy Miller. And you pick up another $10,000, man.
Yeah, I wasn't quite sure it would work. Like I was telling the guy there earlier, I just kind of eked out there a little bit, and it kept feeling good. And I need to go in harder than he's going in to try to get the edge coming off, because I wasn't sure I'd be that good off. But, man, it just really paid off. This car, like I say, was flawless. Hoosier tires were just absolutely perfect. And the racetrack, once again, the Sawyers gave us a great racetrack to race on. And there's not too many places you can come here and race like this, and I just love coming down here.
Well, let's bring in General Manager Clark Sawyer. What's in the cooler? Clark?
Great job tonight. Ultimate Series, just a great show, and you've been a great champion to this event.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
There's your winner, Steve Shaver!
Sportsman Division is underway here at Phil Sawyer's Virginia Motor Speedway. Johnson in second in car number five. Davey Pullen in third in car number nine. Inside your top five.
Strategically,
watching Bristol all over again. That was one hell of a run, and you drove the wheels off this thing. Unbelievable.
First thing, thoughts and prayers with a friend of mine that's having some health issues, Steve Haynes. Want to let him know we're praying for him. I got a lot of people to thank here. Hope I don't mess this up.
Hey, you have all night.
Thank you, buddy. That's good. I got a lot of people I want to get down here in the picture, too. Already, all y'all. I want to thank Roy Skaggs for letting me drive a car. I told him ever since I met him he's been trying to kill me, and I've been trying to break him. So all my crew, John McGee, Herman Gant, come on board with us. Louis LaHockey been with me for years. Mike Hayes, Artie, Roy, Sput, all the guys, man. Hope I didn't leave nobody out. I tell you, I want everybody over here in the picture, all the people over there, I want everybody to get in this picture. Thank Mike Hayes, and like I said, John. But it was a good run, and, you know, I had a lot of confidence in my boy Todd behind me. He drove me clean. He touched me a couple times, but I'm going to tell you what, it was a good race. I hope it was entertaining for the fans.
Absolutely. Let me tell you something. Walk us through those last few laps. What was going through your mind? It had to have been the most intense thing you've ever done here.
What was really going through my mind was the five car and Todd. And you know what? I had a lot of faith in him. I knew he wasn't going to do anything crazy back there, but I figured we'd put on a good show for the crowd. And I want to thank all the fans for coming out and supporting this event and supporting all the drivers. And from the bottom of all our hearts, we want to say thank you. And that's for everybody here.
Well, thank you very much. Fans, one more time, Junior Kreiner in victory lane here at Bill Sawyer's Virginia Motor Speedway. That's it for us down here on the racetrack. We'll send it up to you, topside in the tower.
Don't forget, we take next week off. We return on Saturday, June 2nd, our four weekly divisions. If you've been drinking and you can hear this, please hand your keys to someone that hasn't. Budweiser reminds you, responsibility matters. Thank you for coming out on behalf of all the staff here, Bill Sawyer, Clark Sawyer, and the staff. We say see you later.